Hello, everybody. ABC Killer here, and we are back on the next interview. This is a very special interview. I found another podcaster, and he's got more subscribers than me. So usually I do everybody that has less subscribers, but he reached out to me, which is awesome for him. This is Decoded Reviews and Podcasts. So, hello, Decoded Reviews and Podcasts. What would you like me to call you today?
Hi, Keith Legion's fine. As I'm one of the personalities on there, I'd feel really bad for the rest of the guys if I was Mr. Decoded Reviews when I'm half the team.
They're like, what? You took all of us? You can't do that, man. That's not cool.
They're like, I'm not showing up for the next podcast. My next
Ever.
podcast after this one will just be, "Hi, Keith Legion here. Everyone left me."
Yeah, no one loves me anymore. It's not fair. All right, so Mr. Keith, what made you start YouTube?
Well, I originally started a blog spot to where I was doing written reviews. I was in a pretty dark spot in my life at that point. I was moving from Utah to where I'm at now, and I needed something kind of as a transition point, like an anchor. And that was writing reviews. And after a while of writing reviews, I realized, hey, people don't all like to read, right? IGN itself, which is a site I follow, was switching from written reviews to all video reviews at the time. And I decided, you know what, why not give it a shot? I used to love video editing when I was younger, so just decided to start up YouTube.
Now, if you only knew that now, or knew then what you do now,
Right?
So, give us a little brief. What is your channel about?
So, to make things super confusing, I like to break it down into three different ways. One is the reviews. So, we've got things such as video reviews for movies, TV, big music acts, and I'll explain why I'm specifically saying that, right? So, all sectors of media. Then we have our podcast, which, I get a bunch of friends together, I get other YouTubers together, and go ahead and we basically break down topics instead of where you've got people like Kind of Funny, right? Who go, we're going to do one topic for 15 to 20 minutes and release it. I kind of like to give people bang for their buck, right? We do three topics, and I've started integrating to where, if a topic's not vibing with you, you can just click the annotation or I give you a timestamp to move forward so you don't have to listen to that any longer. But a lot of the times we get pretty heavy into it. And there's a lot of debates in it. So it's actually a lot of fun to listen to and have other people contribute. And my last one, which is something I started when I did Blogspot. I actually had a family member who was in kind of an independent band, and he was saying, it's really hard for us to get any press. And I said, well, why don't I review your album? So I created what's called Independent Closet, and it's for any music artists, right? Or, I mean, I've expanded it to movies. I just haven't finished an actual review of it yet. But any independent act that, maybe needs a little bit of coverage or needs a little bit of love. For example, Megaran, who is a rapper, will be my next one that I finish. After I finish a very small time one here in Michigan that I'm reviewing, just to kind of give them a little bit more of a push in the door. As a big act, it's like, oh, cool, someone's using our music, copyright strike. But as like a younger act, you're like, oh, please use my music, like get my name out there a little bit more because any press is good press, right? But yeah, so those would be the three sections I would consider of Decoded.
Yeah, those copyright strikes suck.
Oh, good Lord. I mean, I haven't had one yet. The 21 Pilots review. The funniest part of that review, and you actually saw the video where I talk about YouTube, we need to talk, but there's a joke at the beginning of the 21 Pilots review, which is a part of the Stressed Out music video, and there's all these sirens that show up, and it basically shows that the YouTube video got taken down because they think that you're a thieving pirate. So the thing is, when I originally submitted it into YouTube, that was the only part of the review that got hit for a copyright infringement.
The
So I had
part
to
that
lessen.
wasn't even supposed to be part of the music.
Right. So I had to shorten it because YouTube has a system where after 30 seconds, it starts going, what's this video? And searches for it, right? So I had to cut it down to like 20 seconds as opposed to 28 because it was just too close.
How dare you use your own content?
How dare you augment our content for a joke? We don't take kindly to jokes.
We don't like your jokey kind around here.
Exactly.
So if you when you started YouTube, if you would have known now, which or if you would have known then what you know now, would you still would have do it? Would you still continued?
I think the only probable change, and I think a lot of YouTubers get there eventually, is right off the bat, I would have hit the ground running talking to other people, right?
Yeah.
Because
instead
you have
of
two
doing solo.
Yeah, well, you have two paths in YouTube, right? Path one, which is what a lot of YouTubers do, which I don't suggest, is they find a multi-channel network and they just jump in. They're like, please, please, give me money. And
it's no. Look,
it's not, right? And you've got big YouTubers like PewDiePie, but they're huge. Markiplier's huge, right? And they're a part of those multi-channel networks, and they get 90 to 95% of their profits. You, Joe Schmo, who's got candy reviews and has like 3,000 subs, you're not.
Yeah, you'll be lucky to get 80% of your cash.
Now, the only way that I could foresee doing that is if in the backdoor talks to become a multi-channel network, because I know one day, right, I do want to be a part of one, but the only reason I want to be a part of one is, for example, if you've heard of Normal Boots, they have other YouTubers that you can collaborate with, right? It opens that avenue a little bit easier to collaborate. So I wouldn't join a multi-channel network for more money. I would, as part two, or, you know, line two of trying to get more people, which is what I wish I would have done to begin with, you know, collaborate more. Anything that opens up those avenues of collaboration, just like what we're doing right now, I think is the best for people, because going it alone is cool, but it's
very hard.
Oh yeah, and you're eventually going to have to start collaborating with people. Like, if you shut the doors on collaboration, right, some people will be like, oh well, you've only got 30 subscribers, so they'll shut the door on it, right? And that person a month later has 200 subscribers somehow. And why? Because they did three or four collaborations, and those three or four collaborations netted them about 20 to 30 subs per each, right?
Yeah.
That person just beat you. And it's and I don't want to say beat you in a way that's negative. Detrimental.
Yeah,
yeah, because, and I think you agree, YouTube should really be about, and this is probably going to go into the tangent of my biggest issue with YouTube right at this moment that I yell about on a podcast episode we just recorded, but we need to be in it together. We're not against each other. Your channel is not against my channel. We're in this together. In any way that we can collaborate, we can make more content, right? And we can get our name out there is just better. It doesn't need to be, oh, well, I need to destroy your channel and take your subscribers, because, buddy, you're not going to get anywhere.
Yeah, it's going to be an endless circle.
Yeah, exactly. And that's why I've opened up the avenues for people, you know, being on the podcast, right? I'm just like, hey, man, send me an email. Or I send them an email. And I've had a few people that are like, bro, could you stop stalking me? I'm like, I'm not stalking you. I just, I know that we could profit from each other being friends on YouTube and being friends in general. And I've met a lot of really cool people doing that.
By the way, your living room arrangement looks great from the front yard.
From the tree.
from the tree.
From the tree, your bedroom looks even better. Like,
No, go away, weirdo. Yeah, people come into YouTube, unfortunately, and they think that everybody's competition. And in a way, it is competition for everybody. Because, you know, for example, if you use the exact same channel as mine, I would have to convince your subscribers to come over and subscribe. But I don't necessarily want to take down your channel. I just would like to share. So, Sarah, it's like the old piracy thing. Sharing is caring. So I don't understand why everybody wants to just come in and just tear up each other's channels. It's easier just to collab and get it done over with instead of just, you know, like you said, shutting the door.
Yeah, and I could understand a paradigm shift that's kind of happened right in YouTube, because back in the day when no one was really watching YouTube, yes, kids that are listening that are 13 and younger, there was a time that no one really watched YouTube. It was you were fighting to keep people coming back. You were fighting for that literal email. They would send out emails like, hey, so-and-so just uploaded a video. Nowadays, because there's so many videos being uploaded, they're not going to sit here for everything you're subscribed to and tell you that. But back in the day, I get it. You literally were fighting for people to get their eyes onto YouTube. But now that everyone's eyes are on YouTube and they're just looking for more content, yeah. I mean,
could you imagine how many emails you would get a day if you just had your two-day subscription list?
Oh my God.
Every time somebody uploaded, you'd get an email. You'd have to make a dedicated email account just for that.
Oh yeah, it would all go into spam. It would eventually just all go into spam.
Yeah, screw it.
Yahoo or Gmail would be like, you know what? Gmail especially. Gmail's like, you know what? I know that we're a part of this, but screw it. We gotta put this somewhere.
Yeah, this is getting ridiculous.
Yeah.
So, for a, have you ever stolen a street sign?
No, I know a few people that have stolen a street sign. I've actually been in the presence of someone stealing a street sign, but I didn't help and I didn't drive the car out of there, so I don't count it.
You don't count it because you didn't drive the car, but you knew about it.
I mean, I was sitting there. I mean, look, listen, what happens in fraternities stays in fraternities, okay? So as long as I'm sitting here like, hey, there's no cops, like as long as all I said was that, I didn't steal it. You stole it.
Yeah, there you go. What are you doing? I don't know how they got there. It's not my car.
I don't know who they are.
Yeah, I thought that was just construction workers trying to put it back up, and you know, it fell over after they hacked it off at the bottom. There's replacing it.
Exactly.
So, do you sing in the car?
Yeah, I actually, that was kind of one of the avenues and the reasons to come in. So I just actually finished writing an EP with another person, right? I play every instrument in the book. Like if you can name an instrument, I can either play it professionally or I can dabble with it, right?
A kazoo. So, can you play a kazoo?
A kazoo or a kazoo? Because I've never heard of a kazoo.
Maybe my music teacher was just an idiot.
No, like, but yeah, no, it was one of those things where, you know, I love playing music and I love listening to music, right? So like, why not do something with that, right? And the thing is as a band, it's really hard to have people listen to your music if you don't have anybody to listen to it. So, I mean, it was one of those things where, you know, be into YouTube and kind of sync everything together with what I want to be.
He plays every instrument now.
Yeah. I mean, it started with guitar, right? When I was in sixth grade. And then I picked up the drums a year later. I picked up the bass after that. I started taking vocal lessons so I could sing. And then I just started dabbling on the piano. And once you learn music theory, piano really opens up. So I learned piano and I was like, oh, well, this is easy. And then I had a buddy who played viola, a friend that played cello. And I was just like, oh, show me how to, like, you know, mess around on this
stuff.
Yeah. And I had another friend who, you know, played clarinet, played trumpet. So I was like, hey, show me how to, like, dabble on this. So it was just one of those things. If I get bored, I'm just like, I'll just learn a new instrument, except the ukulele, because I hate the ukulele.
It's like a mini guitar.
No,
hell.
Well, and the problem is like when I was on my college campus, people would, when you walk around with a big guitar, you're committing to that guitar for the day. You are committing to that huge thing that you are carrying. If you have a ukulele and you're playing Somewhere Over the Rainbow, you didn't commit to anything. You just were like, oh, this was in my backpack. Like, no.
Yeah, it was just laying around. So I picked
exactly.
it up.
Exactly.
Here, commit to this. Smash.
Right?
So, have you ever gotten a speedy?
No, actually I have not. Oh, knock on woods.
Damn it. I've got like 70 of them damn things. My insurance is... Then again, I got a cool car, so... Yeah. Always ridiculous. Anyway, this is not my review. So what is the hardest thing as of now to do on YouTube? Like the editing? Is it the finding people? Is it the recording?
That's a good question. I would probably have to say somewhere between editing and exposure. And what I mean by exposure is making sure your tags are on point, making sure that, you know, you're releasing it at a good hour and a good day. I recently found a software called TubeBuddy that I've been working with. And the cool thing about TubeBuddy is it basically is like, hey, here's where you rank when you put in, you know, when you put in this tag, here's what page you rank on, right? Like, 1 billion, thank you.
560.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean.
Lost. Just say lost. That's all you need to say.
It's like trash can. But, so, you know, editing is editing, right? You know, I can write a review in 20 minutes, but, and I actually talked to my little brother about this because he didn't understand. For a lot of people, right, they go, oh, that person, you know, wrote the review, they recorded it, they did the images and the editing. It's like a 5-minute video. That probably took you like an hour. Like, no, it didn't. Like that 5-minute video probably took between 4 and 5 hours to complete.
Yeah.
From start to finish. And a lot of people don't understand that, right? So that's kind of the hardest part.
Just the encoding for YouTube alone, if you do an average encode for every minute, it takes 2 minutes to encode. So there's already double the movie. So whatever the movie is, just to render it out,
yeah,
it's already doubled.
Yeah, and with that itself, right, that's not my struggle. My struggle isn't that, right? Because, I mean, once it's, like, on YouTube or once it's, you know, processing and rendering, because that's the longest time frame, you can sit there and edit it in about an hour, but then it renders out, and the in-and-out effects take, like,
forever.
20 minutes.
Yeah.
And then the actual export takes an hour and a half, and you're like, oh, my God.
And then if you have a crappy computer, like some people that start out with YouTube, you're like, wow, I cannot use this thing until it stops.
Oh, yeah. No, I couldn't do YouTube until I got my beast computer. I just couldn't do it.
Built?
I could. No. I got an Asus. Because the thing is I wanted to build it, but I'm also really lazy.
Oh, my. But I built mine 6 years ago.
Well, I used to build them when I was at Best Buy, because I worked at Best Buy for a really long time.
Hey, so did I.
Yay! I feel like either everyone has worked at Best Buy or Subway. Those are the two places you will work at in your life.
Yeah, or Walmart.
There it is. But you know, it was one of those things where I was in the middle of a lot of work. I was doing overtime, doing all this other stuff. And I was like, look, I'm just going to buy it. And it's not bad. It's expandable, right? So thankfully, I don't have to buy a whole new motherboard and things like that if I want to expand. But, you know, I got it for a good price, thankfully.
Well, yeah, if you work at Best Buy, you get it for 10% above cost.
Well, yeah, but I don't work at Best Buy anymore.
Yeah, I miss that. My HDMI cables are now $40 instead of $10.
Yeah, and you walk in there and you're like, I know how much this is worth.
Yeah.
Like, do you want the back tie protection? No.
No, I want you to stop screwing me over.
I want you to check me out and smile. Don't ask for the reward zone card. I'm never coming back here. Amazon was out of it.
Yeah, that was the only reason I'm here.
Exactly.
By the way, you stink. So, you got any advice for starting YouTube channels besides collaborate?
Don't.
Wow, I think I've heard this before. Like, this is what I was told. Don't do it. Stop while you're ahead. Are you stupid?
No, I would give the standards first, right? So standard advice is collaborate as soon as you can, right? Don't be afraid to talk to other YouTubers, and don't be afraid to look for smaller YouTubers to collaborate with, because everyone has bigger YouTubers on their lists, right? Look for things in Reddit, right? Don't promote on Reddit, because if you promote on Reddit, you're not really getting anything. But if you go over to Reddit...
The hardest thing to do is promote on Reddit, because everything you post, you have to reply to two posts, or it's spam. The Reddit is it's an awesome place to advertise if you already use Reddit on a daily basis.
Exactly, right? And I started using Reddit on a daily basis. You know, I use like partnered YouTube and collab YouTube, but a lot of times I'm on there just reviewing people's stuff because that one day where I'm like, hey, review mine, nobody can sit there and be like, wow, you just randomly came in here. Hey, check my status. I've done 40 different reviews on this site. So calm down.
Yeah, chill your tits.
Yeah.
That almost said it in a bad word.
But the other thing I would give you is, you know, don't be discouraged. It takes a lot of time, right? Like I said, I did a blog first. So a lot of people that read the blog, it was easy for me to then bring them over to YouTube, because they were like, this is what we've been asking for. I'm like, okay, cool. Then you shouldn't have a problem subscribing, because you know I already have 50 posts over there.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's don't be discouraged. And the worst advice I can give you, because it sounds the worst, is your friends will like your Facebook page. Your friends will subscribe to your YouTube. Your friends won't watch your videos.
They suck.
Random people will. So don't be afraid to talk to random people. Don't be afraid to email a new subscriber. When somebody subscribes, don't be afraid to send them a message like, thank you for subscribing. You know, if you want us to review anything, let us know. Like, don't be afraid to do these things, because your friends will be like, oh, yeah, I really like that video. And it's like, well, I just talked to 100 friends and I only have 40 views on the video.
Yeah.
So, you know, don't be discouraged when your friends aren't watching it. Just utilize their numbers to make you even bigger.
And you can ask them for advice, but they're still not going to watch your crap.
Yeah. I mean, very rarely will they watch it. It's going to have to appeal to them, right?
Family's another one that's like that, by the way.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's great. I mean, I think I have like... I go to work and I work with a whole line of like 60 people, and they all is like, oh yeah, we watch your stuff. And I can only go talk to one of them and be like, oh, did you know that, you know, blah, 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 at this point when you just passed it, and it was just sitting there like, you know, there was a bobblehead right there and Fallout, and you just passed it. Like, there's a bobble? What the hell? Why, you actually watched it? That's a first. One out of 60.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, and that's the truth, right? Random people will support you more than your friends and family will, which is sad, but it's because they're, you know, either busy with their own agenda or they're busy following celebrities, right? And that's why I'm very big into small YouTube and medium YouTube, because, you know, I think that there's not a lot of people fighting for the little man. There's a lot of people fighting for the big man. There's a lot of people fighting for kind of the medium upper class. But, for example, Trilby Reviews, right? He was in the YouTube We Need to Talk. And, you know, him and I have talked for a little bit, you know, about collaborating and about, you know, just YouTube in general and what needs to change. And he was really excited that people were making a YouTube We Need to Talk because he started it. And then Doug Walker came out this week and made it hashtag WTFU, which kind of, I understand what Doug was trying to do, and I have nothing wrong with Doug. I think he's probably a very great person from what I understand about him from other people. But you ended up making a split in class, unfortunately, on YouTube, because you have smaller YouTubers that are trying to get their voice out there and have a video type that they're making. And instead of making that video type, you create your own catchy thing they have to go back and do. I mean, if you watch Trilby, he actually goes out and he made a YouTube Need to Talk. He started it, right? Uh-huh. And then last week after, I want to say probably within like 12, 15 hours after Doug Walker made his, the Nostalgia Critic, for those of you that don't know who Doug Walker is, he made, what's it called? He made a hashtag WTFU. And at the very beginning, he says, YouTube, we still need to talk. This is pretty much just going to be what I said in YouTube, we need to talk. So if you want more information, it's over there. This is just going to be a little bit more condensed. I was like, yeah.
Yeah, thanks. Because
you already made the video. Like, you already stood up for your side of YouTube, right?
Yeah. So you just basically just screwed over the little guy.
And he didn't mean to. And I get you.
Yeah, I mean, it's never deliberate. But it happens.
Exactly. And it's, you know, he got his, he was on, you know, Reddit, and he was, you know, everybody was like, oh my goodness, Doug Walker's talking about this. Oh my goodness. And Reddit was exploding. And I was like, well, he's a week and a half late. The rest of us were talking about it 2 weeks ago.
Yeah. Where the hell was you then?
Yeah. Like, okay, cool. I guess anything can go viral if you just know the right people. All right.
Start talking to people. Bye.
Right. Well, and that's the thing is, if I would have put my video or Trilby's video for YouTube We Need to Talk on Reddit, it would have been considered spam.
Oh yeah,
but
of course.
But because Doug Walker has that amount of people that know him, it's not spam at that point.
Yeah, but you know, that's what you get when you have a lot of people.
Yeah.
For the last question here, that one's inappropriate. Can't do that one.
At what age did you have your first period?
awkward moment. Wait, should I be having a period? Missing something? Oh, would you rather be attacked by a big bear or a swarm of bees?
Am I going to die? Like, am I guaranteed to die?
Not part of the question.
I'm asking, am I guaranteed to die or not?
Who cares? It's a bear or bees. Take your guess.
Because there's a different recovery process for a bear attack than a bee attack. There's a much different recovery process.
Which one do you think you can fight off better?
I would go with bear, dude. Bees you could swat at, but they're still going to sting you. And the thing is like a bear will maul you and probably kill you faster. Bees will be stinging you until either A, you are done and pass out due to pain, or B, if you're allergic, right?
Until you die of, you know, attack. Yeah.
So no, I go bear all day. I watch The Revenant. I'd go bear.
Just hurry up. Make me bear poop already.
Exactly.
I don't know. Bees might be nice. You could always dump down in water.
But then they just sit there right above the water. I'm like, we're raiding.
Yeah.
This assumes that you're near water. I mean,
yeah.
This is a loaded question.
It is loaded. It is very loaded. That's why it's funny. Like, you know, extremely loaded. But anyways, guys, I'll leave his link down in the channel, the Decoded podcast, or Decoded, sorry. I put an R in there. Bad NPC, bad. Go get the muzzle. Wait, what? I'll put the link down in the description and probably annotate the crap out of this video for you guys. All kinds of little flashy YouTube-y things.
So yay!
Please go over to his channel and leave a like and show him some love. And if you like his content, hit that subscribe button. It's not like going to cost you anything. I don't know why you think it is.
Yeah, Twitch costs you something. But
Twitch costs you. Yeah, this is not Twitch. Exactly. We don't pay for our subscribers here.
Damn straight.
As always, guys, take it easy.